What is happening, my people? This is Tim Dodd with the Tim Dodd Show, and today I'm going to show you how to be a LinkedIn search assassin. Find really, 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 really targeted people on LinkedIn using a feature called the Boolean Search Strings. Now, you can do this with free accounts. You can do this with premium accounts. And today I'm going to walk you through both a free account and a Sales Navigator account and how you can use the Boolean to find the perfect people and make sure that whatever type of outreach you're doing on LinkedIn is only targeting awesome types of people. Let's go ahead and jump in. Before we do that, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe because I want to help you be a master at LinkedIn. See ya on the screen. Jump into the Boolean search, and it's going to be a little confusing for a second, but I'm going to actually give you an example and walk you through it. So let's come over here and look at a few things like and we don't use, but I'll just give you an example of what it is. I could say, hey, I need their profile to have social and capital media somewhere on there. The reality is though, is you don't have to have and for it to do that. If you have social media like this, it's gonna do the same thing. There's some other cases where you don't need it, but for the sake of this training, I'm actually not gonna use and, but I wanted you to be aware of it. The next one you need to be aware of is the quotation. So this is gonna be, I want the exact phrase social media in here. So let's see what this would look like. If I put the exact phrase social media, that means somewhere, if I put it up in the keyword part here, that means somewhere on their profile, it's going to be social media people. And I have a search here. You know, we personally help marketing agencies. We're the marketing agency that other marketing agencies hire. We're reaching out to over 500,000 people a month for our team and our clients. And so it's very, very important that you get these targets down. So for this example, you know, I'm reaching out to second, third connection, United States marketing. And with this keyword, I can do social media. So social media people. And if you look down here, public relations, social media, purpose driven, all these are social media people. So that's why quotations is important. Let's say I want to reach out to marketing people, but not social media people. I can put this not in here in all caps like that. And it's going to give me a result of everybody that does not have the phrase social media on there. So I can reach out to all the marketing people except for social media people. And let's see right here. I could also do or. Actually, let's say I'm wanting to reach out to SEO people, but not social media people. I could do like SEO or search engine optimization, right? So I'm doing SEO or search engine optimization. Let's see what this looks like here in the search. So SEO or search engine optimization. Here we go. We have search engine optimization, all these strategies. But parentheses does this cool thing where it allows us to create like a separate, like let's just say I want to reach out to social media people and SEO people separately, right? So what I could do with parentheses is I'll add this parentheses. I'll go, you know, SEO or search engine optimization, but I'll put it in parentheses and then I'll say not social media. So this if this confuses you, I'll give you some more examples down here, like for the title. We can do owner or founder or CEO or chief executive, not admin or EA or administrator. So I'm trying to target any of these people in the parentheses, but I don't want any of these people not in the parentheses there. If that allows you to separate, it says, hey, I want them to have this, one of these, but not one of these. Same thing for real estate. Let's just say I'm targeting real estate agent or broker, but not an intern or associate or an admin. That's how I would use the parentheses. So let's do this as an example. Let's say I'm switching, I'm trying to target SEO people and not social media people. So why would I want to do that? Well, I could split up an outreach because I want to target one outreach campaign to the SEO people and no social media people. And then I could reach out to them. And obviously down here I have owner or CEO or founder under title, because you can use the Boolean under title. You can use it a lot of places, but the main place we would use is like title and the keywords. But like, so now I have the search. I can copy this. I can, you know, save this search somewhere. I want to. I can. So I'll save that. This would be like SEO people owners. Right, so I have that search saved. Now I could do like social media people that I'm gonna save. Social media owners. So I'm gonna split my outreach between these people. So I can come up here and just say just the social media and hit enter. And now I'm reaching out to social media people. So I can split up that search. So one search is gonna be SEO people, not social media. And then one search is just gonna be social media. And that way, if I am reaching out to them, I'm not double messaging them or double connecting. So that's exactly how you use the Boolean. You can use it on the title and different areas. Now just, I have a more in-depth training on how to use that with Sales Navigator, but you can do the exact same thing with a premium Sales Navigator for stuff like title, job title. You can do it for the keyword stuff up here, and just different areas. I have a more in-depth training if you wanna know how to use LinkedIn Sales Navigator Premium to do this, but that's how you would do it on a free search. Boolean's very, very powerful. I hope you got a lot of value from this video. That's exactly how you use the Boolean search on LinkedIn to find the perfect targets. And we're using this specifically to reach out to 500,000 plus people a month for our clients so that they can generate leads and customers. And hey, look, if you're a business looking for customers, you're an entrepreneur, I have a free training at the end that's gonna help you do that. But also if you don't have a business, but you'd like to make an extra $5, $10, $15, $20,000 a month running a side business or even starting a full-time business, I also wanna give you a resource. It's gonna be at the end, link that you can click, and it's gonna show you. So business owners that want more customers, or you wanna start your first company and start getting customers, I have a resource that's gonna be at the very bottom. Before I give that to you, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe only if you got value from this video. If you did get value from this video, that's the only thing I ask. Also, if you have any questions, make sure to ask in the comments. I'm more than happy to engage with you there, help you out, because I'm here to help you really, really level up your business, your life, whatever you're doing. Oh, by the way, that free resource down there below, get it, it's free. I'll see you on the other side. This is Tim, Tim Dodd Show. See you soon.